San Antonio's a big big military bases on here too, man. I was stationed here a long time ago. Yeah, I was stationed at Lackland a long time ago, right? Yeah. It's funny too, looking back at my life, I was thinking I joined the Navy like right after high school, and I was thinking, why did I join the Navy? And I remember all the reasons, because, you know, I was a broke kid living in a trailer park in Southern Ohio. The military's looking at me like, we can get that right there, you know? Because it was like my senior high school, there was about a week run where every day I came from school, there's a different recruiter at my trailer trying to get me to sign up, you know? And they just kept showing up, you know? Because I remember the Marine guy showed up first, the Marine recruiter, and I remember he got out of his car in front of my trailer, and I thought Marines had the best uniforms. When I saw him in that uniform, I said, damn, that looks sweet. I told my mom, I'm gonna join the Marines. Then he walked in my trailer. He was like, Gary, we are the few, the proud. I go, what's that mean? He goes, when it pops off, we the first ones in, we the few. I was like, ooh, I'd rather be part of the many. I'm good on that. The hell are you trying to be first for? Pace yourself, slow down. You're not trying to be first in the fight. You don't know what's popping off. You the first one to fight. Who's second or third? I'll join the third. I ain't trying to join the first. Who's third? I'll join third. I ain't trying to join first. I'll join third. Because I'll give it to Marines. They are better Americans than me. Because you're hearing stories about the Marines. You know, they'd be in Iraq, be in a desert. You know, be. You'd be in a story like you'd be just like 33 Marines would be in Iraq, be in a desert, standing around, and then a grenade will drop in the middle of them, and one Marine will jump in a grenade, take the blow to save the other 32 Marines' lives. I'm like, man, if we're in a desert, and there's 33 of us, and a grenade drops in the middle, and I see it first, either 33 people die or 32 people die. But if one's gonna make it, it's gonna be me. Like, oh, grenade! Damn it! Chris. Chris. The Army guy came to my trailer. He was lying the whole time, lying his ass off. Army recruiter walked in my trailer with a straight face and was like, Gary, I heard you wrestle. I heard you're in your high school wrestling team. I said, yeah, I wrestle. He said, you know, if you join the Army, you could try out for the Army wrestling team, and if you make it, you just wrestle the whole time you're in the Army. I said, sir, I am 3-30 right now. I've won 3 times and lost 30. I am literally the worst wrestler in the state of Ohio as we speak. I didn't wrestle to wrestle. Either come to the trailer park after school, or I can hang out with wrestlers and wrestle every now and then. I go, f*** it, I just wrestle. I don't give a f*** if I won or lost. I used to pin myself half the time, you know? Because every time I get ready to wrestle somebody, I run on the mat, I look across, they be resetting the time clock. I go, you ain't gonna need that. This ain't gonna take that long. You ain't gonna need that clock. I be looking at a guy, I'm about to wrestle him over here, sweating, warming up, smacking his leg, got his headphones on. I go, you're doing too much, man. This ain't that kind of match. This dude listening to NWA, getting all fired up. This is more of a Kenny G type wrestling match. This is smooth jazz. We're gonna do this together. And when I tell you my senior in high school, I won 3 times and lost 30, I didn't beat 3 different people. I beat the same motherfucker 3 times, one dude. He was trying to lose too. Because the first time I saw him wrestle, I go, oh, this trying to lose. My coach was like, how can you tell? Because I try to lose, coach. I can tell when I'm trying to lose. I remember the first time I had wrestled, we was both trying to lose. At one point, we land on the mat right next to each other, both trying to pin ourselves. You trying to lose too. Honestly, the Navy recruiter, he was just the most honest. He ain't promised me nothing but a flight out. That's all he promised me. Because the Navy recruiter walked in my trailer and looked around and went, I can get you out of this. And then he didn't tell me what I was gonna do in the Navy or nothing. I said, what will my job be? I said, what will my job be? He goes, what's it matter? Look where you at right now, kid. You're right, I'll go with you. I remember my first year in the Navy, I made $24,000 for the year. I called my mom. I said, you ain't gotta work no more. You're done, Mom. I got you. 24K, baby. I told you I was gonna do so with my life, man. I remember my first check in the Navy was $512. I'll never forget it, man. You lucky to want Instagram back then. I don't know. Look now, haters. Get on my level. I got another one coming in 13 days. Can't stop, won't stop. 512 every 2 weeks.